After undergoing so many tests to monitor my kidneys, my doctors told me I had lupus nephritis, one of the most common complications of lupus. They said that I would be needing a kidney transplant. Maybe I wasn't necessarily really good at knowing what that meant, so it actually got to a point where it was life or death.
Francia immediately began the process of having her blood and urine tested. She completed a physical and psychological evaluation.
With our situation, because we were kind of an emergency situation, I did everything in like a day. And usually the process takes like 6 months. So it was really fast.
Waking up 2 hours after, and I saw my mom, I saw my stepdad, and I felt okay, I felt really good. And I got to see you and tell you I love you. And then I went back to my room and I started to attempt to fall asleep. And in the middle of that process, I started hyperventilating and there was so much pain there.
Doctors told Selena she'd have to go back into surgery. Her new kidney was turning around inside her body.
My teeth were, I was like grinding, I was freaking out. It was a 6-hour surgery that they had to do on me, and the normal kidney process is actually 2 hours. Apparently one of the arteries had flipped. I'm very thankful that there are people who know what to do in that situation.
She held my hand and she's like, are you good? I was like, yeah, we're doing this. And then they give you Valium to calm you down. I don't remember anything else.
Well, you did a little peace sign first.
Selena and I both went through a depression. We both, you know, she had some complications with hers and she has bigger scars than, you know, I do that, you know, wasn't expected. I remember getting a text message from Selena saying, I'm so scared, I might die. And I was like, what? And I called, man, I was calling someone, and that's when she got the complication where the kidney turned and broke an artery. And she had to go back in, and they actually had to take a vein out of her leg. So she has a scar right here, and build a wall around her artery. Like, this whole
scars
thing.
Don't define you. It's a part of your story.
I didn't tell anyone on set except Kenya the day before. Kenya Barris, our executive producer. And I was like, so remember that kidney I donated? So my sister is from another mister. Because I said it was my sister, which wasn't a lie. It's just, you know, we're not blood related until now.
You are now.
We are technically now. So I told him and I went to set and I had a hoodie on. And I was just like, I don't know what to expect from all of this. And even Selena called me. She goes, are you okay? And I was like, this is the first personal thing that I've ever had come out. Like, I don't know how to react. Thankfully, I had work to distract me. A couple people came up to hug me. They're like, oh my gosh, I didn't know. Which, they used to make fun of me on set because I now go to the bathroom every 5 seconds. If I drink water, I need to pee immediately, which is one of the side effects of it. And so they used to be like, Francia, are you not an adult? Can you not hold it? And now I was like, do you feel like a jerk?
Right, little did
you know. Do you feel like a jerk? You should feel bad about yourself. So now that, you know, they start taking care of me. They're like, where's her water? Do you need to go to the bathroom? Are you good? So I got amazing support from everyone on set. And so it was good.